guys doing?
Good!
Yeah.
Sweet!
Yeah. It's not working right now.
Yeah. Oh, alright, reclaiming my time. Hey, keep it going for your host and for all the action scenes right now. You're doing a great job. I'm excited to be here. I just graduated college recently. You can calm down, it's art school. I actually just graduated from Columbia. Anybody here go to Columbia? Yeah! Oh, shit! I totally didn't know that was going to be the response. Well, hey, man, go, I don't know what our mascot is. What's the mascot? What's the mascot for the morning team? What? I feel like Renegades is the worst mascot for Columbia ever. That's not representative of the school at all. I feel like Columbia's mascot should just be a person wearing like one of those wool hats with the ears on it and like holding a petition or something. Like, anyway, I did just graduate from Columbia. People don't believe that I went to Columbia. And I understand. I don't look like I went to Columbia. I don't look like art school. But I look very bro-y, okay? Let's get it out of the way. I look like I play lacrosse at fraternity parties. Like, I understand what I look like. But I graduated now, so I'm now making the transition from college douchebag to douchebag. So, I liked going to Columbia. I transferred to Columbia, and it was easy to fit in because I was in the theater program, so everyone was just high. It was really easy to fit in with everyone. No one goes sober to a class where you're in bare feet. Like, no one. It was great. I'm a social smoker. I like when I'm high and I see other people that are high because I feel like I'm in a secret club. Giving a nod. But it sucks when I'm high and they're not, and I think they are, so I'm like, yeah, what's up? They're like, who the fuck is this guy? Oh, my goodness. They know now. I like to get high, but not too high, you know? Then you start doing dumb stuff, you know? Like, you know you're too high when you're scrolling through the contacts on your phone for, like, 15 minutes looking for a good song to play? That's not really good. Then I just do dumb stuff. I'll just watch, like, fight compilation videos online for, like, 15 hours. It's amazing. I love fight compilation videos because you can watch from a safe distance behind your computer screen where you don't have to be worried about getting punched in the back of the head. Like, if you're looking at something, if there's nothing crazy in your line of sight and you hear someone say world star, like duck. Duck and run. Someone is gonna hit you with a shovel or some shit. But I'll get all hyped up, like watching it in the mirror, I'll be like shadow boxing, like I fucking wish somebody would, man. I like that. That's not him. Okay. I'm soft. I am. Like despite the fact that I look like a high school bully, I'm soft. It's like Drake and then me. And Drake has two albums called Take Care and Thank Me Later, which are the most politely named hip-hop albums of all time. There's a new EP coming out called That Shit, God Bless You. I like Drake because like rappers used to be gangsters. Drake made it cool to be a rapper who's not a gangster because he just does regular shit. Like his most popular song right now, his most popular line is him saying he only loves his bed, only loves his mother, and then he immediately apologizes afterwards. Like that. That's soft. I'm a big hip-hop fan, always have been. It's tough being a white hip-hop fan though, you know, because sometimes you'll be uncomfortable with like some of the lyrics that are said. Like when you're listening with your friends, like J. Cole has a song where he goes, I came fast like 911 in white neighborhoods. And when I'm with my black friends, I just have to be like, that is accurate, I guess I don't sucks. I get mad. I can't even sing the lyrics of the song. I did a kids bop version. Like, I couldn't even sing the chorus walking over here listening to Biggie Smalls. I was getting pissed off because I was like, yeah, and if you don't know, now you know. Champ, not the same at all. It's just not as fun. I'm going to leave you guys with two quick stories and then we'll get out of here. The first story is not really a joke. It's just something that happened to me. I was working at a movie theater in D.C. a couple summers ago, and I met Ted Cruz. I didn't meet Ted Cruz, I saw Ted Cruz, I should say. And I saw Ted Cruz in the hallway, right? And I was walking towards him. But I thought it was Ted Leonsis, because we're in D.C., who owns the Capitals and the Wizards. So I walked past Ted Cruz, and we had this moment where Ted Cruz and I locked eyes, and like, he knew that I knew who he was. and I knew that I knew who he was. And we just nodded to each other, and I just went, go Wizards. And that was it. Nothing else happened, but anyway. I'll leave you guys on this, and some of you guys are going to hate this joke, but this is a story of hope, okay? This is about the night that I had my first kiss and my first blowjob on the same night. I was 16 years old, okay? I was at this party. There was this girl that I had a crush on, okay? We were hitting it off. We started kissing a little bit. There was drinking involved. One thing led to another, and I ended up blowing a guy in the closet. So... wasn't gay, it was my uncle. Thank you guys for having me.